Let's move on to the battle of the Northerners. This is going to be a great contest between Delhi and Punjab in the second game of this fantastic competition that has finally started for all of us. So without much further ado, let's quickly get into it. This game is going to be played in Dubai, the Dubai International Stadium, and this venue is fantastic to play T20 cricket in. I say that because in 2019, in the Pakistan's T20 competition, the teams that were chasing had a great advantage over the teams that were batting first. 12 times the teams that were chasing won the game, and maybe twice or thrice did the team that batted first won it. So we know what the mantra is. And speaking about the average first inning score, it's not a high scoring round, like I said before. It's only 143, so it's pretty chaseable according to T20 standards and especially IPL standards, considering the likes of KL Rahul, Chris Gayle and Rishabh Pant all playing in one match. So with that being said, let me quickly move on to the teams and let me speak about the head-to-head between Delhi and Punjab. In terms of head-to-head, Delhi have an upper hand over Punjab. Delhi have won 4 and Punjab have won 2. This is since 2017. So I think going into this game, Delhi will go psychologically in a better mind frame. In the next segment, which is basically let's talk numbers. We're going to be speaking about a lot of numbers, so let's quickly jump into that. When the IPL was happening in the UAE, a small part of the IPL was happening in the UAE in 2014, and that time Punjab played 5 matches in this country and they won all 5 of them. So talk about advantage. Punjab do have that mental frame. They will be great going into this game. And when on, as we're speaking about Punjab, I have to talk about the captain, the new captain that Punjab has chosen, KL Rahul. This man has been fantastic for India in the recent past, especially since the 2019 World Cup. He's just been great in the IPL. He's just 23 runs short of getting to 2000 IPL runs, which is fantastic for him. And that's going to be a great achievement if he gets that. And another fact about KL Rahul is that he's going to don a role as a captain in the IPL for the first ever time, actually in T20 cricket for that matter. So I would like to wish KL Rahul all the very best going into this season as a new captain of Punjab. Moving on and speaking about the spinners for whom this IPL is going to be a treat, I have to speak about Mujeeb and Sandeep. Those guys have something in common. They have 30 wickets apiece in T20 cricket in this year, which is fantastic, which is the highest in terms of any international cricketer for that matter in T20 cricket in 2020. And last but not least, I have to speak of a very experienced cricketer from Delhi who recently moved bases to Delhi, I have to say, Ajinkya Rahane. 182 runs he scored in 2014. When the IPL was obviously happening in UAE that time. In those few games, he scored 182 runs, which was the highest by any Indian player in the 2014 leg. Let's quickly move on and let's speak of the predicted 11, the probable 11 that I've gone with for this, both these teams actually. First with Delhi, I want to start, and the fact that Delhi has so many fantastic players, it was kind of hard for me to narrow down, especially the foreigners. So the 4 foreigners that I have gone with are Marcus Stoinis, Shimron Hetmyer, Kagiso Rabada and Sandeep Lamichain. I think the bowling department was kind of sorted for me. Rabada and Lamichain were always going to be my first choices. But when it came to the batting side, I was kind of circumspect about going with either Alex Carey or Marcus Stoinis. But I decided to go with Marcus Stoinis only because of the fact that we already have a keeper in Rishabh Pant for Delhi. I think that's the only reason, but obviously Carey is coming off a century in the last ODI against England. That is another reason that I have to take into consideration. But just because Rishabh Pant is already their first choice keeper, I'm going to go with Marcus Stoinis. And at the top of the order for Delhi, there's another confusion there. I didn't know whether I was going to go with Prithvi Shaw or Ajinkya Rahane. I think Shaw will get the first cut in the first game, obviously. But Ajinkya Rahane's experience is also something that Delhi might consider. The fact that, like I said before, he scored a lot of runs when he was here in the UAE the last time. So this is kind of a tricky playing 11, predicted 11 for me. But I think this looks a solid setup on paper at least, and they would be raring to go. Moving on to Punjab, the fact that Chris Gayle is there, it was again a very hard decision to leave him out of this. But I've gone with my 4 foreigners, and they are Glenn Maxwell, Nicholas Poole, and these two people are. That's fantastic. They're phenomenal. I kind of wanted to give a chance to these youngsters, especially the likes of Nicholas Puran and Glenn Maxwell. Obviously, is just coming off a century, a match-winning century at that. So he's definitely going to make the cut. And the last time he was here, he played really well. Did Glenn Maxwell. Moving on to the other two foreigners, they're Mujibur Rahman, the mystery spinner. We need him. Spin assisting wickets. And I've gone with a fast bowler. I again had to make a choice between Sheldon Cottrell and Chris Jordan. I didn't know which they were going to choose, but I think this is what their lineup is also going to look like. Otherwise, their batting looks pretty much sorted. KL Rahul at the top. We have Mandeep Singh, Sarfraz Khan. We have Mayank Agarwal as well as there. It looks a very formidable setup, and the youngster Ravi Bishnoi will also, I think, find his place here. So this looks a fantastic setup for me as well. It took me a lot of time to make this prediction. The Cricket Tracker audience has finally decided on who they want to go with, who they think is going to win this contest, and they have gone 55% with Delhi and 45% with Punjab. I don't think there's a mystery there. It's simply because of the head-to-head. The recent past 3 years, Delhi have had an upper hand over Punjab, and Punjab is still trying to find that one impact player other than maybe KL Rahul and Chris Gayle. They're just maybe trying to find that one player who can be the Superman for them. Every team has one, and Punjab, I don't think, have had one in a long time now, and that's why people have also gone with Delhi. And most importantly, this is the time that I also give my prediction. I also think that Delhi is going to go with and win this first contest, simply because of the fact, like I said before, of the head-to-head. And I want you guys to do the same thing in the comments. Tell me what your predictions are going to be, and if you like the video going ahead, hit that like button, comment on what your teams are going to be, comment on what your prediction is going to be, and most importantly, if you guys already haven't done it, then hit that subscribe button and the small notification bell also right next to it. And I'll see you guys with more such videos every day.